Hello students, welcome back to our YouTube channel Concepts in Science. The next double membrane organelle which we'll discuss in this video is mitochondria. The discovery or the credit for the discovery of mitochondria was given to W. Fleming and R. Altman. But the term mitochondria was given by C. Benda. These mitochondria are rounded or disc shaped or Suchet shaped structures present in all cells, whether they are plant or animal cell, except in prokaryotes. In prokaryotes, in place of these mitochondria, mesosomes are present, means infoldings of plasma membranes are there. And these mitochondria are double membrane organelles, as you can see in this diagram. This is the outer membrane. And this one is inner membrane. This inner membrane has foldings. And these foldings of the inner membrane, like these foldings, these are called as cristae. And these foldings of this cristae increases the surface area for enzymatic activity. And the space, means बाहर वाली membrane और अंदर वाली membrane के बीच का जो space है उसको हम यहाँ पे कहेंगे inter membranal space. अब जो इंटरमेम्ब्रेनल स्पेस है ये भी दो तरह का हो गया. एक तो ये स्पेस जो दो क्रिस्टा के बीच में है और एक जो स्पेस जो बाहर की साइड पेरिफेरी पे है. तो जो दो क्रिस्टा के बीच का जो स्पेस है इसको हम कहेंगे इंट्रा क्रिस्टल स्पेस और जो पेरिफेरल स्पेस है दैट इज पेरिफेरल space. And the space which is enclosed by this inner membrane, ये जो inner membrane के अंदर का जो space है like this or this surface, this is called as matrix. Inside the matrix soluble proteins and dense soluble proteins are there. Here in the matrix a single circular DNA also present, that is single circular DNA. Along with this 70s type of ribosomes are also here, ribosomes. Now see, these foldings of inner membrane called as cristae, these cristae contains enzymes, different enzymes for aerobic respiration, or we can say that enzymes or different complexes for the electron transport chain and Krebs cycle are present here in the inner membrane of mitochondria. So all these reactions like electron transport chain and Krebs cycle, or we can say aerobic respiration, occurs here in the inner membrane of mitochondria. So here these ATP synthase enzymes also present, also called as oxisome, as I told you that here ये ATP synthase enzyme है और Krebs aerobic respiration के लिए enzymes है. So ATP production for the cell, that is adenosine triphosphate, energy currency of the cell, that is produced here in the mitochondria. इसलिए mitochondria को हम बोलते हैं power house of the cell. इसलिए कहेंगे power house because it produces energy in the form of ATP, adenosine triphosphate. ठीक है. अब देखिए अगर हम in case of animal cells, एनिमल सेल में अगर देखें तो 95% जो एटीपी है दैट इज produced by aerobic respiration, that means inside the mitochondria. While the rest 5% of the ATP are produced by anaerobic respiration. In case of plant cell, during the daytime, chloroplasts are the major site of ATP production. While during the night period, these mitochondria are the major site of ATP production. During daytime, chloroplast, and during night time, mitochondria are the major site of the ATP production. So, as it can produce energy, so it is called as powerhouse of the cell. Along with this, inside the matrix, here single circular DNA is also here. So, with the help of this single circular DNA and 70S ribosome, it can produce half of the protein of its requirement. क्या करता है ये अपनी requirement के आधे protein खुद बना लेता है. Protein produce कर सकता है. इसलिए हम इसको बोलते हैं semi-autonomous unit. Semi means half autonomous regulating. क्या कहा हमने इसको semi-autonomous unit? Because it can produce half of the protein of its requirement with the help of single circular DNA and 70S type of ribosomes. And it depends on nucleus for other half of the proteins. So, इसको हमने कहा powerhouse of the cell and semi-autonomous unit. अब आता है कि जो mitochondria है ये कितना होगा किसी cell में. The number and shape of the mitochondria differ and in different cells. Its number depend on the physiological or volume of the cell. Physiological condition of the cell. वो cell जिनको ज्यादा energy की जरूरत है उनमें number of mitochondria ज्यादा होगा. जिनमें less energy required है वहां पर number of mitochondria कम होगा. जैसे अगर हम देखें oocyte stage में मैक्सिमम नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया होते हैं. इसी तरह स्पर्म का जो मिडिल पार्ट होता है दैट आल्सो हैव ए लार्ज नंबर ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया व्हिच प्रोवाइड एनर्जी फॉर द मूवमेंट ऑफ द स्पर्म. रिगार्डिंग द ओरिजिन ऑफ माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया, इफ वी कंपेयर दिस माइटोकॉन्ड्रिया विद ए प्रोकैरियोटिक सेल देन वी कैन फाइंड दैट in the prokaryotic cell there is foldings of membrane, plasma membrane jinko humne kaha hai mesosomes. To yahan bhi jo iski jo membrane hai it has foldings. Aur mesosomes mein enzymes hote hain aerobic respiration ke liye. Yahan bhi inner membrane mein kya hai enzymes hai for aerobic respiration. Similarly in prokaryotic cells single circular DNA is there, here also single circular DNA and 70S type of ribosomes are also here. That means a prokaryotic cell enters into the another cell and after some time they become closely associated with each other and start symbiotic association and start working as a energy producing organelle or mitochondria. That means these mitochondria are produced by entry of a prokaryotic cell inside the another cell. दूसरा अगर हम देखें जो prokaryotes हैं, जो bacteria हैं, they replicate by binary fission and these mitochondria also replicate by the binary fission. That means if these are the prokaryotic cells which enter into the another cell and start behaving as a energy producing organelle, that is mitochondria. This is all about the mitochondria because it produces energy, so called as powerhouse. It produces half of protein, so it is called as semi-autonomous unit. About the next double membrane organelle, we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.